Hi, in this video, I'll be showing you guys how to create an active and inactive button, like the buttons you see at the very top. So in the selection pane, you can see over here that the inactive buttons are being shown right now. But when I click on this active button for USA, that the USA button would be active right now while the inactive button is hidden. So in reality, there are two buttons. So when I click on the inactive button, it will hide the inactive button and display the active button. I'll be showing you guys how to do that on the page. So to create a button, you could go ahead and hit the button drop down and hit the blank button. So for demo purposes already, I created these four buttons, and I'll be showing you guys how to create inactive buttons first. So to do that, I like to make the background 50% transparent on both the inactive buttons. And what helps me to distinguish them too is if I go rename this in the selection pane, so it'll be USA and active and Canada active. And I'll have to create two new bookmarks. So I'll call this USA hyphen button and Canada hyphen button. And I will assign these actions to the buttons, the USA button and the Canada to the bookmark Canada button. So for this to work, I'm going to have to bring the inactive button and stack it on the active button. And I will hide the active buttons first to create the reset button. So the reset button is good in case I don't want to default on any of the countries. So that will happen when I will hide both of the active buttons and only display the inactive button. So I'm going to reset my bookmark and update it. So if I just want to display the filtered country for USA, I will hide this inactive button and display the active button. Then go to countries, select my filter for United States of America. And go ahead and update this bookmark. And I'll do the same thing with Canada. So hide this active button, display the inactive USA, show the active Canada button. And change my filters for Canada. Then update the bookmark. So for testing wise, I'm gonna hit the reset button and see if everything USA is filtering correctly and Canada is filtering correctly. This is another name we like to call this. It's just for easy buttons. So have set criteria for filters. So the end user does not have to go in and change the filters. That's why it's important to have the reset button in case that they want to use other filters that they are not set for using these buttons.